Europa Oil and Gas has signed a farmout agreement with Cairn Energy, which will now partner Europa in an early stage exploration project offshore Ireland. Well, for more, we're joined by Europa's chief executive, Hugh Mackay. So, Hugh, looks like a positive development. What does it mean for this particular license option?
It means we can now accelerate the exploration of this licensing option. And that will start this summer with a 3D seismic program. And so that takes place summer 2017. And I'd imagine by summer 2018, we'll have a processed product. And I'd hope to turn that into a prospect inventory by the end of the year. And once we've got that, we'll know whether we want to reach for the drill bit or not. And it's very positive that we're able to push ahead with that and get seismic done now. And the size of the prize potentially in 16-19 is 1 billion barrels, and which might seem a lot, but on the other side of the basin, an FEL 313, where we have got 3D seismic and we have got a CPR by ERC Equipoise, the audited prospective resources are 1.5 billion barrels of oil equivalent gross mean unrisked prospective resources. So, you know, we're being, I suppose, cautiously optimistic by saying the size of the prize could be 1 billion, and we'll get on the path to understanding more about it this summer, and there should be more announcements over the next few months as seismic contracts get signed and the boat sails out of Cork to start acquiring seismic.
Okay, so we'll obviously be watching out for news flow coming out from you, but concurrent is your partner Ken, because this news, your news, came out at the same time that Cairn announced a separate deal with Providence. Yeah. So it seems significant. You know, what's your view on Cairn's new commitment to offshore Ireland?
Well, I think it's fantastic because they've now, on this west flank of the Porcupine Basin, Cairn are now in three licenses. So they have a strategic position. They're in 1618, which is immediately to the north of 1619, and now they're in FEL 214 with Providence. And they'll be drilling a well this summer that's going to test Druid, which is a Paleocene prospect, and Drombeg, which is a Cretaceous fan. So if they have exploration success on that license, well, it's good news for us because Cairn are going to know exactly what they found and exactly what the technical read across is. And that may encourage them to, or might encourage the joint venture partnership to move things forward with, to drilling. And we've got a 30% interest in the license still. And so we've got a material position. And I'd hope that by 2018, when we'll have our prospect inventory, that we might be aware of the results of three wells in the Porcupine Basin. So the ability to farm out or even to raise money to support drilling may have completely changed from where we are right now. And the other positive thing is this is the first farm out in Atlantic Ireland since 2013. So in April 2013, we announced that we'd farmed out to Kosmos, as did Antrim. And then that seemed to create a sense of urgency, and suddenly another seven farmouts were announced. And I'm hoping that this movement today will create a similar sense of urgency, and perhaps we may get other farmouts starting to come out of the woodwork over the next few months.
Okay, in terms of a sense of urgency, you know, what's your view on possible timetables for drilling on Europa's acreage? You know, does this new activity accelerate your plans?
Well, in 1619, it definitely accelerates it. But realistically, if you don't have a prospect inventory until towards the end of 2018, you're probably not going to be drilling until 2020. You might be able to push it forward to 2019, but 2020 is probably the most realistic. And that's just the sort of flash to bang time for in deep water basins, where it takes time to process and interpret and 3D seismic. And then, you know, it takes about a year to program an exploration well. But I think if there's exploration success, that might accelerate things. And you might feel a lot more confident in accelerating exploration drilling if there's been oil found in the basin. You know, that will be a game changer. In the same way, we think that the Statoil's Bay du Nord discovery in the Flemish Pass Basin offshore Newfoundland was a game changer for the Flemish Pass Basin. Up until then, and the reason we refer to Flemish Pass a lot is when you restore the Atlantic before it split apart, Flemish Pass and the Porcupine were next to one another. So there's a lot of geological similarity between the two. Flemish Pass was underexplored, sporadically explored for 40 years, a bit like the Porcupine. Deep water, harsh environment, a bit like the Porcupine. And it's almost like a game of chicken amongst companies, you know, who's going to drill first? Statoil did, and in the course of a three-well drilling campaign, made a big discovery at Bay du Nord. And then the floodgates opened. Everyone's very brave after there's a discovery. $2 billion of exploration commitment has been put into the Flemish Pass. So that's what exploration success can do in terms of transforming the basin. We're not there yet with Ireland, but I think if we can get some exploration success over the next few years, then it will be transformational.
I am enjoying your visual narrative, but I'm just musing about that comment you made about flushing more farmouts out of the woodwork, as it were. So, you know, as the farmout processes continue, are you now more confident of securing more deals? You know, what are your hopes and expectations for the rest of the portfolio?
Well, the priority, we've got seven licenses. I was going to say they're all available for farmout. Well, six are. One down, six to go. The priority has been the South Porcupine licenses, so we have three more licenses to farm out in the South Porcupine. And then we have two licenses in what we call the Greater Corrib area, so that's up around the Corrib gas field. And so that's those are gas prospects, shallower water, lower risk. And then we have the Porrick Basin, which is on the sort of edge of the Rockall Trough. Those ones will formally launch the farm-out processes for them in 2018 once we've completed a technical work programme. Although, if someone wants to look at them immediately, we'll of course accommodate that. But the priority right now is the Porcupine. The data room has been open since January 2016. I didn't think it would take this long, but we've got the first one away. And what I can say is the market has changed from a push market this time last year when we were trying to push the farm outs out to a pool market where potential farm inees are coming to us. Now that oil prices stabilized at around $55, big companies have done their downsizing and portfolio reorganization. They're now starting to think ahead and thinking about doing exploration, and Ireland is a place that they're thinking of doing that exploration in. So we've now, our leaderboard has, you know, in September there were about half a dozen companies on it. We're now back in double figures again. So it's a positive market, and I hope that getting the two farm outs being announced today will perhaps encourage some of the others that they can't sit in the sidelines forever. The train is leaving the station, and this was the same situation in 2013. Everyone was thinking it's Ireland, there's no hurry. And that's, you know, certainly last year people thinking, well, there's no hurry. Perhaps there might be a sense that maybe we should get a move on.
Okay, so you are talking about urgency. You said you were surprised that it had taken you so long to get here, but the train's now, you know, leaving the station. So I'm sensing that it's not just for your company, but within the sector there is renewed confidence and urgency.
We support, you know, we're delighted that Providence are going to get, you know, got their farming partner in and have a well drilled. There are other companies farming out in the basin, and we wish everyone the greatest of success, because what we want is an active programme of drilling in the Porcupine, well, in Atlantic Ireland. You know, my belief, and this is a personal view, I suppose, is that over the next 5 or 6 years, there's going to be somewhere between half a dozen and a dozen exploration wells drilled. And at the end of that, we're going to know whether we've got a new hydrocarbon province or not. And if big companies want to be part of that position at an early stage, then, you know, perhaps they need to think about getting into licenses. Now, of course, if you're a big company, you can always buy your way in later on the back of exploration success.
Is that an invitation?
well, no, but it is. You know, it is a reality. People were only interested in buying Cove, which really is the last really big success on AIM, after they'd found all that gas in Mozambique. And once the risk had been taken out of it, then you know some of the biggest companies in the world were crawling over broken glass to buy them for $2 billion. You know, that's kind of the definition of success, I think, for an AIM listed oil company. And I think that could come in Ireland if there's exploration success. And I think the exploration drilling is coming, and the results will have to speak for themselves. But I hope that the first well out of the traps this summer will be a success. If it isn't, there'll be two wells in 2018 that I'm aware of. So hopefully they'll be successful. And then, you know, we've got a drillable prospect already in FEL 313 that we're trying to farm out. And there was a lot of seismic shot last year. The logical outcome from that is drillable prospects at the end of this year. And the seismic shot that's going to be shot this summer by us and others will be drillable prospects at the end of 2018. So the exploration pipeline is going to start delivering exploration wells, and hopefully they will get drilled, because Ireland suffered from one well every 20 years, and if it's a failure, you go off and cry for another 20 years. What we need is a program of wells that will comprehensively tell us whether we've got a new hydrocarbon province. There's six plays out there. We don't know which one's going to work. Hopefully all of them, and they all need tested.
Okay, so hopefully not tears, just terrific news. Hugh Mackay, Chief Executive of Europa Oil and Gas, thank you very much. It's always an education with you.
Thanks you. Very much. Bye.